What's up, y'all? It's your girl Crew, and I am here to give y'all an update. I wanted to say, first off, happy December, happy Sagittarius season. I am so glad to be out of the retrograde. I cannot thank everybody enough for the amount of love, stories, support, and everything that y'all have given to this project alone, that y'all have given to me alone. I just hope that, you know, we keep rocking with the kid and, you know, the BLA and shit. I hope that y'all also too have had a really, you know, dope ass year. You know, I hope that everything that needed to stay in this year stayed, and I hope that everything that had to fucking go had to go. Y'all just continue to do what it is that you need to do and what you want to do, how you want to do it, how you want to does it moving forward, not just for 2020 and beyond, but 2019 into Swag Surfing into 20 for the 2020 Black Lesbian Archives US Tour.
Yes, we are.
We getting ready for it, baby. We getting ready for it, baby. Tentative places that we gonna be kicking it. And if y'all have any days or any places that we should hit, let me know. I am in Atlanta, for those of y'all that don't know. For those of y'all that don't know, for those of y'all that don't know, your girl is in Atlanta. I'll be out here for about 3 months until the actual tour kicks off. So we're gonna start this thing off in Atlanta. We're actually gonna go down to Florida, come back up, then go to Alabama, New Orleans, Houston, San Antonio, Austin, Dallas, New Mexico, Santa Fe, Albuquerque, Phoenix, Arizona, San Diego, Long Beach, Compton, Vegas, Oakland, Portland, Vancouver, Canada, Seattle, Denver, Colorado, Kansas City, Indiana, Detroit. I'm trying to scratch some stuff out, so it's all going to have to be revised, but you get the point. New York, Buffalo, all the boroughs, Philly, D.C., Maryland, Baltimore, Richmond, Columbus, and then Chicago, back to Chicago. About a mark from February, March, all the way up until June. Now, those are the tentative dates. But if there is a place on there, not days, places, if there's a place on there that you feel like the BLA needs to come to, or the BLA needs to hit your girl up. I will be providing the phone number that you could call, and also the email blacklesbianarchives@gmail.com. If you're trying to get in touch, let us know, okay? And we'll figure something out. I recently submitted, shout out to Avion PR, a fundraising campaign with iFund Women. If y'all don't know what iFund Women is, definitely go check it out. Women entrepreneurs who are campaigning and fundraising for such that business, organization, and things like that. I was gonna go the GoFundMe route, and I still might go the GoFundMe route just so I can have a little bit more of a reach. And I have went the Facebook route. I'm just waiting for things to get approved on that end. Okay, so I'm gonna say this, and for those of y'all that I have already talked to, the people that I've been like, you know, this is my 12th house Aquarius thing going on that I'm still trying to like get over in this lifetime. Yes, I am gonna be turning BLA into a nonprofit. At first I was like, nah, F the government, this is a community organization, blah, 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 whoop-de-woo-woo-bam. And now I'm just like, well, in order to get things moving, and in order to get things going, and in order to make things officialized, and just some of the stuff that I did into the research, I figured, all right, so the funding is gonna go into that, as well as building the Her Story BLA van. I started looking for vans. I have a picture in my mind of what the van's gonna be. Doesn't mean it's gonna be exactly like I got the picture, but you get it. I will be building the van, be buying the van, and building the van out. Van will actually be accessible to everybody who want to come through, because I also will have like the mobile, it'll be the mobile history van. Let's just say that you missed one of the events in the city and you couldn't make it, but I'm gonna be there for a couple extra days or something like that, and you didn't get a chance to check out the archives, you can personally hit the Black Lesbian Archives up, and you can actually view the van, or come to the van and view the archives within the van. So I will have like a little, you know, pop-up shop set up, you know, for y'all that want to come through. You know what I mean? Like, this is our van. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is our mobile van. Appreciate it. Really take care of it. Really something that we can use to, you know, keep continuing and moving this project, and also in a collaboration of other projects on, you know. So that's where I'm at with that. Also, covering promo costs, printing costs, and media costs. Now, this fundraiser, this is like a permanent fundraiser to get things moving, popping off, like started. But we will have other methods to be funding this project as well. This is the kickoff after the kickoff, like I kind of said, the second wing of the tour. I will be having, and I'm actually in the process of setting up workshops. So if you're in Atlanta and you want to come kick it and you want to learn more about archiving, I will have those available for, you know, I'm calling it my residency while I'm here in Atlanta. Information coming soon, to stick with your girl. Make sure you follow the YouTube channel, because I will, even though I will have updates on the website, I will be doing more updates through video and audio versus, like, I have held on to these archives for so long now, and I've had conversations about, you know, what digital archiving looks like, and I have such an old soul, old spirit, I'm so old school that I'm just like, well, we could just take the archives everywhere. Nah, we can't take the archives everywhere. I cannot carry the archives with me everywhere. But, you know, while this tour is one of my ultimate goals for this, not even just for the tour, but just for the BLA, is actually to have a house. A house to house not only the BLA's archives, but other archives, women of color, lesbians, having like an archival place. And I'll get more into that as like things go and things come and things like that. I'm just kind of racking off my mind right now. But yeah, I do appreciate everybody for your support. You can hit me up personally at crewmakedo on Instagram. Hit me up if you ever want to talk, or, you know, want to share or some ideas, or want to share space, or whatever the case may be. You know, I'm here for that. Personally, for me, I've been like coming off this, like I kind of talked about it in the recap video for the kickoff tour. I've been coming off like this not necessarily a high, because I don't ever think I'm really coming off of a high. I'm always like, there's always like energy in me to stay up, but like, you know, just doing a lot of healing work. I've had to come to terms with a lot of things that have been transitioning personally for me in my life. You know, accepting this new chapter of my life and embracing this new chapter of my life. It's even as exhilarating as I know it is been. It takes a lot out of your girl, a lot out of the Jedi, okay? So I've been recouping, recovering, you know, getting my body, getting my health right, getting my spirit right, getting my mental right. And man, I'm ready to blast off, and damn, it feels really fucking good, y'all. It feels so good, and I really truly appreciate y'all for coming through. Like, yo, if ain't nobody told you thank you this week, I'm gonna tell you thank you, and not even about BLA shit, but just thank you. You know, I love you. If nobody else has told you that they love you, I love you. Keep that shit going. Don't let nobody come in front of what you're trying to do. Don't let nobody stop you. Keep it moving. And, yo, you know where the fuck to find me. You know where to find me, baby. And if you out in Atlanta, holla at me. Okay, baby? It's all love. It's all love from here. Black Lesbian Archives, crewmate 2. I will see y'all soon.